been an issue with displacement and gentrification in our community for several years now. I think that the sleeping giant is awake now. I think this is the time, a time in history, a very important time in history, to address gentrification, to address displacements. It seems like a gold rush out here for some people, and we don't believe that we're going to be taken advantage of. We're not just objects that you can just move us around in that way. And this is all about community. This is actually the epitome of community coming together for keeping what's ours, what is rightfully ours as people, as community. I think you even said it, Mr. Interviewer, that internal colonialism is the issue at hand here. And so this is what we're doing here to address that. About 10 years ago, our mission district organization, nonprofit, mission district serving nonprofit, got an eviction notice and was displaced. And we were still serving the mission district, but from the Soma, right? And nothing from the Soma, but we love our barrio. This is our neighborhood. And, about 8 years into that agreement, our rent doubled. You know, it went from about $1,600 to almost $4,000. And so I don't know if any of you guys got... had a rental increase like that before, but it's not fun getting that. You know, my family's experienced the same thing right now in the mission, and we're longtime Mission District residents. And so pretty much you want to talk about the small site acquisition program, which allowed Homie to be here in the neighborhood and come back thanks to a local nonprofit developer. And so here we are. This is our beautiful home. Nonprofit was able to purchase the building and save the tenants of the building. So there are about eight units in here. So, you know, thank goodness for that. A homie has a home, and we're able to serve our community
right
the way we always have.
And that's it.
So I'm another lifelong resident. My name is Carlos Guttierez from the Mission District. And whether you've been here for 60 years, like my family's been, or 6 years, a lot of these people that are here from our community, they care about the well-being of our community. And we've seen a lot of changes. And contrary to some people's belief, we actually embrace change in our community. But this change that we're seeing today is unnatural. And we can have it. We can stop some of this unnecessary change. And we're talking about the evictions, of course, but we're talking about developments that don't really keep our community as a whole in mind. You know, the people that are evicted as a result. We're here because we care, like I said, about the well-being of the residents. And can we truly say that? And not all developers are the same. We have some great developers out there, but can we truly say that these developers here today really care about the well-being of the Mission District? You got to think about that, and ask yourselves, is this project necessary for the community? Does this project think about the Mission District as a whole and the residents as a whole, and not to leave anyone out or exclude anyone out? We embrace a lot of these changes, but let's hope they make sense, though, for the long term and short term as well. So thank you for your time.
Thank you. Next speaker, please. 80s move. Let's go. Come on, don't be shy.
All right, Deanna, it's your turn. Ready? Reel her in.
Come on.
Rope her in, Rob. Rope her in.
Oh my God, no. It's gonna be.
Come on, do it. Do it.